going on, everybody out there? This is Popular Stranger, and we are back at you again today with another Madden 20 Ultimate Team video. Series 5 is here today. There's a lot going on in Madden Ultimate Team, and I got a lot to go over. We're going to have several videos coming out, hopefully over the next 24 hours. Apologies that this is the first video of the day. The plan was to get home early from work, knock out a bunch of videos for you guys, but that just didn't happen. And some of you guys might know I usually come home during my lunch breaks to bring you guys afternoon videos, but here in Syracuse, the weather was really bad. The roads were terrible. I just didn't want to risk rushing home in these conditions to get a video out. And, you know, so we're after work now. And in this video, we're going to talk about leveling up, getting XP, because you guys might know we got a level cap today. And you guys want to get those rewards as fast as possible. We got three solos that are going to help you guys do that. So let's talk about the level progressions and what we're getting. We took a look at these yesterday, but if you want to see them now that they're live, all you go to your missions tab, go to series progression, and go to Mutt level. Now I'm already at level 82. At level 81, very important here, there is a pack, a 90 overall fantasy pack. It costs 350 points. It's about $3.50. It contains an 86 overall quick sell Julio Jones. That card quick sells for 160K. Great value. You guys know I don't encourage you to spend money in this game, but when we're talking $3.50 for 160K, absolutely worth it. Level 82, Legend Fantasy Pack. If you can get that tonight, open it tonight. Lamar Jackson still in packs. Stephon Gilmore, CMC still in there. Some good cards to try to pull right now. Level 83, Torrey Holt upgrades and solos. Level 84, 45K quick sell. Level 85, we get a 96 overall power-up pass. Very important because some of those ultimate legends that were revealed already, we're talking Trey Polamalu, we're talking Kelvin Megatron Johnson, finally a wide receiver, are 96s overall. If you can get to level 85 tonight, which I'm going to show you how to do right now or very soon in this video, you could have Megatron tomorrow, because think about it. He's going to get a solo. This is his first wide receiver card. You're probably going to get his power up for free. He has no other cards on the path to that 96. It's going to cost you some training, but training is really, really cheap right now. You could have Megatron for free tomorrow. How about that? Level 86, we have some more packs, and that 91 overall pack is going to be 400 points. That's $4. You get another 96 overall, scratch that, 86 overall, coin quick sell card. Another 160K. We're talking $7.50 for 320K. You just can't beat that. It's a great deal. 87, Legend Fantasy Pack. 88, more Torrey Holt collectible and solos. 89, 45K quick sell. Level 90, you get another 97 overall. I shouldn't say another, but you get another 90. I said another again. You get a 97 overall power-up pass. Some of the Ultimate Legends coming out are 97 overalls. I think Warren Sapp was a 97 overall. He's been revealed. This is going to be his first card of the year. You're going to play his solo tomorrow. You're going to get his power-up for free. And if you got this power-up pass, I'm not saying it's probably going to be the best choice, but you could have that Warren Sapp for free tomorrow if you use this guide on how to level up. So let's talk about it. There are three solos that you can do. Some of them are, you know, there's pros and cons to all three of these. I'm going to go over all three of them. The first one is probably going to be the most popular, but it's still not my favorite. You want to go to Mutt Heroes. You want to go all the way down to Booth Breakers and choose the very first one, which is Technicolor Commentary. So we're going to go ahead and load into that, and I'll give you guys my explanation and details on this one first. So this solo is very unique because it gives you double XP, and I think that's why a lot of people like it, of course, because it gives you the most XP. But the downside to this one is it's a little more difficult than the other solos we're going to show you. And it can tend to take a little bit more time. And sometimes when you're getting that double XP, if it's costing you the same amount of time as the easier solo, it might not be worth it. All right. But we are going to play it anyway. We have faster cards, better cards in the game than we did 4, 5, 6 weeks ago. So that helps out. My go-to play for solos, we're in the Raiders offensive playbook, trips tight end. We're going to run PA slot corner. Now, I have 99 speed, 99 acceleration. Tyreek Hill, you run this play, put him on a streak. You can cancel the play action. The only problem is that the defense, they just got a little more speed. I mean, that was Tyreek Hill so fast, he overran it. But as you can see, he still made a lucky catch. The defense, they're just better. No matter how good your cards are, they're better. So this one on average, usually, and that was a really bad throw by me, this one on average usually can take 2 plays to complete. So when you talk about time spent trying to complete it versus the XP you're getting, it's not always going to equal out. Now, are you going to get some one-play touchdowns fairly easily? Of course you are. But I mean, look at the defense screaming at me. Computer's so unpredictable sometimes when it comes to solos. The other thing to note is that you're kind of stuck with Drew Brees in this solo, and sometimes he has a noodle arm, we just gotta be honest. But we finally got into the end zone, there's 220 XP. Now what you wanna do, very important here, is go to replay challenge. Instead of backing out to the main menu, this is how we stack XP. Now I know there's a new mechanic in the game where you get your bundled rewards, and some people are fearful that you're not getting your XP. You are. There were some server issues earlier tonight where XP was coming in late. So we're going to talk about why you want to back out to the main menu every once in a while, but it's cool to do replay challenge for like 10 to 15 minutes and then back out. So I think we're going to get enough coverage here to where he's wide open. I think they had a linebacker on him. Like I said, it's going to work sometimes for you, sometimes it won't. And it's the unpredictability of this solo is which kind of bothers me. But when it works, it's fantastic. I mean, 220 XP in one play, by far the best method when it works. We'll run it one more time. You can see we got a DB here. You know, you see Tyreek's a little glitched out there, and it just, you know, that's going to happen. And this is a 99 speed overall card. You just got to hope that the defense, the CPU, just plays like stupid coverage on you or puts a linebacker on him. This one, you want to try to pass lead to the outside, but once again, it just noodle arm Drew Brees. This is why it's not my favorite solo. Now, maybe you have a different play that works better for you more consistently. This is one that I just, you know, felt comfortable running all year long. But it's just, I don't know, man, this defense, I think I've said it enough times. It's just too good sometimes. So once you're done, you're doing this for 10 to 15 minutes, you're eventually going to want to go to return to challenges. This is going to bring you back to the main menu, and you're going to get all of that XP that you earned throughout that run. Now, if you don't get to the XP screen, I would kind of stop. I would get on Twitter, look around, because XP just sometimes, the servers go down, it doesn't count. But as you can see, the 3 times that we completed it, we got our 660 XP. Now I'm going to show you 2 other solos, ones that I think are far more easier and just honestly better. For the next one, this is a new one that I've never showed, but I think it's kind of catching some steam. It's the NFL 100 section, and I believe it's week three, release number 2. We're actually going to go to the Adam Vinatieri solo. So we're going to be kicking field goals. Remember I said all of these solos kind of have pros and cons. This one is by far the quickest. The cons to this are it only gives you 90 XP. And also, with the last one we did and the next one we're going to do, when you think about those plays, you're earning offensive passing yards, offensive yards. You're earning touchdowns. And that Booth Breakers one, you're earning double touchdowns because everything's boosted there. All these are going towards your career milestones. It's not really an instant reward, but that's why I like the passing one over this one. The next one I'm going to show you is still my favorite. This one's quicker. The XP is pretty good, but it's not counting towards the bigger picture, and I just kind of like, you know, that's a pretty good goal there. So this one's simple. I'm probably really going to miss this field goal. We'll try to aim it over here a little bit. Hook over there for me. All right, L's in the chat for me missing a field goal on a solo where I'm trying to show you guys how to get easy XP. But it's quite simple. They give you Vinatieri. All you got to do is make the field goal unlike we did the first time, and boom, that's it. This one, again, the fastest, probably the quickest, but it just doesn't give you those other milestones. You're going to go to replay challenge, go to play game, pick your field goal. Like, once you kind of get a repetition down here, you know, you're going to breeze through these. You got a Netflix account, you got Disney Plus, watch some movies, come watch me on twitch.tv/xpopularstranger, whatever you want to do. Once you do this for 10 to 15 minutes, and I highly recommend backing out every 10 to 15 minutes again, just in case there are server issues that you might not know about, you're going to go to return to challenges. Once that's done, we're going to get back to the XP screen, we're going to get our XP. I think I only made 2 field goals, right? So we should get at least 180 XP once it loads up. And he's second now, and there it is, the 180 XP. Like I said earlier, they did do the bundle rewards thing. People are a little confused or scared that they're not getting their XP, but it does count. So last but not least, and this is the one that I've been showing you guys for probably series 2, 3, 4, and 5, is Baker Mayfield, NFL Epics, week number 10, moment number one. I think there's one or two other solos within the Baker Mayfield string that people like to use, but this is the one that just works best for me. This one has the same idea as the Booth Breakers, literally just try to get a one play touchdown. The difference is the defense is terrible. So we're going to go to our same formation. If you guys got any money plays that work in solos like this for yourself, leave them down below in the comment section. Let's help each other out. Maybe somebody doesn't run a playbook that I'm running, which is the Raiders, and they want to try something different. But we're going once again to Gunn Trips tight end. We're going to put Tyreek Hill. And just notice the difference in separation here compared to Booth Breakers. Like, he's just easily going to outrun him. All you got to do is rack catch it. You can sub your quarterback in on this one. Baker Mayfield is good enough to get the job done for this solo, and this is why this one's my favorite, just because it's the easiest and it's, you know, the less time consuming. We go to replay challenge, play game. We go to recent plays, pick our play. Like, it's just repetition once we get there. You can cancel the play action, you can let it go through, but he's just gonna smoke the defense every time. And even if you got, like, you don't even have to have the best Torrey Holt will get the job done. At this point, you really only need like 95 speed, even like 93, 94 would probably get it done. And that's why this one's my favorite once again. So these are the best ways to level up, get those rewards. Remember, the goal right now is that 96 and 97 power up pass. Unfortunately, there is no level 90 like end game pack. Maybe they'll surprise us with an ultimate legend pack tomorrow if you're at level 90. Maybe they'll surprise us with something else down the road. I don't know, but power-up passes are the main objective, plus those legendary packs, those quick sells, some really good rewards, and that's how you level up really, really fast in Mutt 20, especially for Series 5. When we get Series 6, we'll be doing the same thing. If you got any other solos you want to add to the list, also leave that down below in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. My name is Popular Stranger. I'm out. Peace.